What's up, everybody? Frank Valkyria, welcome to the channel. Today, we're doing a first time reaction. This was also a request coming from you. You? Yes, that's you. So let's go together and check it out. I was also requested that I'll do a cover of this song. Now I'm curious. Let's go find out what's gonna happen next. Also, please subscribe if you want. It's free. It's cheap. Cheap. It's free. Eh? Let's go! Click. Click. Hey! This already feels like it could be like the 20s. Very old-fashioned engraving kind of recording. Was it on ceramic? They use those rolls, those cylinder.
Do dia que nascemos e vivemos para o mundo, nos falta uma costela que encontramos num segundo. Às vezes muito perto desejamos encontrá-la, no entanto é preciso muito longe ir buscá-la. Vejamos o destino de pracinha brasileiro.
I have to say, first of all, yes. Second of all, I like this type of stuff. You know, I'm a sucker for all the French chanson, Edith Piaf and Jacques Brel. You know, there was this period that I was just, especially as soon as autumn came, I was so much into Jacques Brel, especially while painting. I just love all this, this period. And so this reminds me both because of the recording, also a little bit the voice, this beautiful, really dark, thick voice of Jacques Brel a little bit. So, for me, yes, right up, Mia Gioconda, Vincente Celestino, probably Italian origin, maybe.
Partindo para Italia, transformou-se num guerreiro, e lá muito distante de espontar o amor sem estas palavras a uma jovem quando viu. Italiana, la mia vita ci sei tu. Io ti voglio tanto bene, partiremo tu insieme, ti lasciare non posso più.
Where did you go? Oh, that's lovely. Singing in Italian. That's great. Now I understand why you want me to cover this. What a lovely... This has all the kind of flair of those great crooners of the 20s and 30s and 40s and 50s, all the way up to... I mean, it's a very peculiar style. It's a little bit like... This is as if it was this period where opera music was toned down a little bit, you know, so this orchestral opera, like more popish oriented, you know, you still had the assemble around and you have those beautiful voices. The melody always gives space to the singer to just go full belting into the notes, you know, this beautiful power. So sometimes the melody, now you recognize it, this type of stuff, of course, after 50, 60 years, probably more, of course. But still, you listen to this, classics, very, very beautiful.
Italiana, voglio a te, piccola bionda, hai il viso del... amore, le tue labbra sono i fiori, tu sarai la mia Gioconda.
All right, you're moving to Italy, eh? We got the other way around here. It's like I'm slowly like, all right, do I go to Brazil or not? Do I go to Brazil or not? I know we both both you know, to my Brazilian audience, of course, I'm talking to. You live in a wonderful country, and I've been lucky enough to grow up in a beautiful country, especially where I come from in the south of Italy, close to the sea. I was really blessed as a child to grow in that environment, you know, like every time I think of my childhood, I always like kiss the floor, we say in Italy, because it could have been so much different, you know, like so fortunate to be able to play in between olive trees, running around bare feet, a little village with just one church and a little square, playing football with my friends, chasing each other on a bicycle, and then on one side you turn and you see like the Gulf of Naples all the way to the Vesuvius, just climbing up, and on this side the island of Ischia, and then the island of Capri. This is what I saw as a child growing up. This was my landscape, you know, 250 meters from sea level, all sloping down towards Massa Lubrense, and then the bay, just beautiful. So this song somehow also brings that flair of the beautiful Italy of the 50s, you know?
Vencido inimigo que antes fora varonil, recebeu a febre ordem de embarcar para o Brasil. Dizia a mesma ordem, quem casou não poderá levar consigo a esposa, a esposa ficará.
Seems like a classic waltz, so to speak.
Teu então bravo ao dar baixo e ser civil, embarcarás amada para os céus do meu Brasil. E enquanto ela esperava lá no cais napolitano, repetia estas palavras no idioma italiano.
As long as you either went there to her or she went there to you, it's all good. Huh? A lovely, happy ending.
Brasiliano, la mia vita oggi sei tu. Io ti voglio tanto bene.
Io ti voglio tanto bene. Very good, very good, very good.
Chiedo a Dio che tu venga, ti scordar non posso più.
You cannot take it anymore. Yes, I can understand.
Brasiliano, sono ancora la tua via.
Hey, Vincente Celestino, I'm just thinking like baritone, tenor. So far, I would say more towards baritone. Beautiful, beautiful voice.
Io sposo hai lasciato questo cuore abbandonato di chi amasti di Gioconda, di Gioconda.
Right, we really got the whole full like opera style ending on the higher note. I will say a baritone here. Beautiful, beautiful tone, incredible performance. Most likely this stuff anyway, it's recorded. This is the beauty of those recordings. This is literally recorded live, you know, from the beginning to the end. So in matter of fact, it's a true performance. You know, it doesn't matter if it was recorded in studio or there was an audience in front, because at the time you just literally goes like, okay, you go in the boot, click, boom, started, you sang the whole thing through. So that alone, it's freaking amazing. Nowadays, not a lot of people do that anymore. I really enjoyed this. What a lovely surprise of something classical. I assume it's either like an immigrant that went to Brazil and he wrote a song, or the other way around, or it's a Brazilian of Italian ancestry. Either way, it's pretty cool. As long as you got reunited and you didn't get abandoned and with your heart, and with your Gioconda, hopefully. So guys, this was really nice. If you want me also to review stuff a little bit further back, totally up for it. Also, if you want me to review things that come from other places around the globe, always up for it. As you can see, the channel is getting a little bit more eclectic. And the reason for that, it's also because we try to do content, first of all, to have more fun with new things, and also to do content that we can monetize ourselves so that we can grow in that direction as well. So we will keep doing a reaction, don't worry. So check around, subscribe if you want, like the video or not, you know, so it's all up to you. Sometimes I get people getting really mad about the more boisterous, humorous reactions sometimes that we do with the guys. Obviously they miss the point, they don't understand that we're just fooling around a little bit, not offending anybody. People should be like old enough to distinguish between when you're mocking somebody and you have sort of malicious intent that you want to diminish the you know, the artistry, or even if you don't like somebody, you want to diminish it with that intent, or you're just goofing around. There is a huge difference, and sometimes I don't think that comes across. But then again, you cannot please anyone, and I just want to say fuck you, yeah, to those people that don't understand. I'll see you later. Always spread love. Ciao. Ciao. That was awkward.